story this morning. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has congratulated US President-elect Joe Biden on his election victory. Prime Minister Modi and Biden also reiterated their firm commitment to the strategic Indo-US bilateral partnership. During the call, the two global leaders also discussed issues of mutual concern, including the COVID-19 pandemic, climate change and cooperation in the Indo-Pacific region. This was the first interaction between the two leaders after Democrat Biden defeated incumbent President Donald Trump in the U.S. presidential election. Now, a release by the PMO stated that Prime Minister Modi warmly recalled his earlier interactions with Biden, including during his official visits to the United States in 2014 and 2016. Joe Biden had chaired the joint session of the U.S. Congress that was addressed by Prime Minister Modi during his 2016 visit to the United States. The interaction between the two leaders came on a day External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar exuded confidence that the ties between India and the U.S. will expand further under Biden's administration, noting that the U.S. president-elect was part of the period when the bilateral relations underwent a radical transformation. Now, Biden is known to be a strong proponent of closer India-U.S. ties since his days as a senator in the 1970s, and he also played a key role in getting the approval of the Senate for the bilateral civil nuclear deal in 2008. The strategic and defense ties between India and U.S. witnessed major expansion during Barack Obama's presidency, and Biden as the vice president had played a key role in it.
In 2014, when Prime Minister Modi came for his first official visit to United States, it was the then Vice President Biden who hosted an official lunch for him. Then again in 2016, during the very well and famous address to the U.S. Congress, it was Vice President Biden who presided over the joint session of U.S. Congress. So they very warmly recalled those interactions. Prime Minister Modi also extended warm congratulations for Vice President-elect Kamala Harris. This is a proud moment for our Indian Americans in the United States, and she has a source of inspiration, and India is also very proud of her achievements.
The Prime Minister also conveyed his congratulations to U.S. Vice President-elect Kamala Harris. He said, and I'm quoting here, "Her success is a matter of great pride and inspiration for members of the vibrant Indian-American community who are a tremendous source of strength for the Indo-U.S. relations." And now for more on this, Siddhant Sibal, our principal diplomatic correspondent, is live with us from New Delhi. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, as you know, Prime Minister Modi has congratulated President-elect Joe Biden. How do you see India-U.S. relations panning out now?
Well, this is official now that the first interaction has happened between the Indian government, the Indian Prime Minister, and the President-elect Joe Biden. And the key focus areas can be divided into the issues which are, of course, being discussed globally as well. The COVID pandemic, climate change, and above all, Indo-Pacific. Interestingly, both the Indian readout, the readout by the MEA, the tweet by the Indian Prime Minister, the readout by the Trump, transition team shows that Indo-Pacific remains a key focus area. Indo-Pacific is a concept that gained momentum under the U.S. President Donald Trump and the Indian leadership. And this is a concept which is seen very suspiciously by the Chinese, but it also shows that how whosoever comes in Washington, whether it's Donald Trump or the continuity which is being maintained by Joe Biden, the issue of Indo-Pacific will be the top priority in which India will play a key role. But if you look at Joe Biden, he has, of course, interacted with India previously as well as the Indian envoy talked about, and as you mentioned. But if we can describe it under four major headings, first as a senator, He had written a letter to the then US President George W. Bush asking the unilateral sanctions to be removed against New Delhi. Then, of course, as the chair of the Foreign Affairs Committee, he worked to make sure that the India-US nuclear deal of 2008 is passed in the Senate. Then, of course, as the US Vice President, he had played multiple roles, whether it is hosting the Indian Prime Minister in 2014, 2016, or whether it is making sure that there is close partnership in defense relationship. Because remember, under the Obama-Biden administration, India got a major benefit when it comes to the defense partnership. That was the start of the closed defense bilateral relationship. And even as a candidate as well, we know that Biden had talked about close relationship with India, the special bond Washington shares with India. So clearly, this is a continuity that will grow, and whosoever comes in Washington, as the Indian government has been saying, this question was often asked during the election in the United States, that how things can change for New Delhi if Biden comes. The Indian government used to respond that this is a bipartisan relationship, and it doesn't matter who comes, because this close relationship is must celebrated primarily because of the close people-to-people relationship.
Also, I just wanted to ask, what changes do you think can be expected now with this transition?
Well, there won't be many changes, but there will be more strengthening of relationship between Washington and New Delhi, because both need each other. There has been a lot of closeness when it comes to defense partnership, and we have seen how there has been an increased geopolitical changes, and China is something that has been a cause of concern in Washington and New Delhi. And even when Biden comes, do not think that the pressure will be less on China. We do expect the pressure to grow on China from Washington, given the fact that a new normal has been set by US President Donald Trump, and for that new normal, New Delhi is a key component, a key stakeholder, especially when it comes to the Indo-Pacific concept, or in fact Quad as well. We know how there have been meetings of Quad, the Quad Foreign Ministers meeting, and in fact even as we speak, the Malabar exercises are taking place in the Western Indian Ocean with the participation of the Australians. So we do expect the like-minded countries and the close partnership between Washington and New Delhi to grow and change. Whatever change comes, it will be positive in terms of more close engagement. We do expect when the US President takes charge, the new US President takes charge in January, after that we do expect much more high level engagement between the two sides. We know that under Donald Trump there was a new closeness which was formed, a new personal rapport which was formed between Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the US President Donald Trump. We do expect the new the personal rapport to continue with the Biden administration as well.
All right. Okay, Sudhan, thank you so much for joining us with all those inputs. We will be closely tracking this, of course, as you know.